This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Franz Lieber, March 18, 1798 or 1800 October 2, 1872, known as Franz Lieber in Germany, was a German-American jurist, gymnast and political philosopher. He edited an Encyclopaedia Americana. He was the author of the Lieber Code during the American Civil War, also known as Code for the Government of Armies in the Field 1863. The Lieber Code is considered the first document to comprehensively outline rules regulating the conduct of war, and laid the foundation for the Geneva Conventions content. 1 Biography, 11 Education in Germany, 12 European Activities, 13 American Educator and Writer, 14 Civil War Activities, 15 Preserving Confederate Documents, 16 Diplomacy, 2 Family, 3 Works, 31 Writings on Penal Legislation, 32 Occasional Papers, 33 Translations, 4 Notes, 5 References, 6 Further Reading, 7 External Links. Biography. Franz Lieber was born in Berlin, the capital of the Kingdom of Prussia, while still in Germany. Lieber joined the Kahlberg Regiment of the Prussian Army in 1815 during the Napoleonic Wars, and was wounded during the Battle of Waterloo. The year of his birth has been debated because he lied about his age in order to enlist. Education in Germany. Lieber did not receive a normal gentleman's education. Returning to Berlin after the Napoleonic Wars post 1815. He studied hard and passed the entrance exams for the University of Berlin. However, he was denied admission because of his membership in the Berliner Burschenschaft, which opposed the Prussian monarchy. Moving to Jena, Lieber entered the University of Jena in 1820 and within 4 months finished writing a dissertation in the field of mathematics. As the Prussian authorities caught up with him, Lieber left Jena for Dresden to study topography with Major Decker briefly as soon as the Greek Revolution of 1821 broke out. Lieber volunteered his services. European Activities. Lieber fought briefly in the Greek War of Independence, and then spent 1 year, 1822-1823, in Rome tutoring the son of the Prussian ambassador, historian Barthold Georg Niebuhr. While there, Lieber wrote about his experiences in Greece. The result was published in Leipzig in 1823 and also in Amsterdam under the title The German Anacharsis. Lieber returned to Germany on a royal pardon, but was soon imprisoned once again, this time at Köpenick. There he wrote a collection of poems entitled Wien und Wann Lieder, Songs of Wine and Bliss, which on his release, with Niebuhr's help, were published in Berlin in 1824 under the pen name of Franz Arnold. Lieber fled to England in 1825, and supported himself for a year in London by giving lessons and contributing to German periodicals. He also wrote a tract on the Lancasterian system of instruction, and met his future wife, Matilda Oppenheimer. Lieber left England upon receiving an offer to manage a gymnasium and swimming program in Boston. American Educator and Writer. Lieber moved to Boston in 1827. He came with recommendations from Jan, as well as from General P. Fuel, who ran a swimming program in Berlin. Lieber was also acquainted with the outgoing gymnasium administrator, Charles Fallon, both believing thoroughly in the importance of training the body along with the mind. Fallon had established the Pioneer Gymnasium in 1826. Lieber's Boston Swimming School of 1827, a new departure in the educational field in the United States, became such a feature that John Quincy Adams, then President of the United States, went to see it. The gymnasium had a difficult time once the novelty had worn off, and in the face of caricatures in the newspapers, it closed its doors after 2 years in Boston. Lieber edited an Encyclopaedia Americana. After conceiving of the idea of translating the Brockhaus Encyclopedia into English, it was published in Philadelphia in 13 volumes, between the years 1829 and 1833. At this time, he also made translations of a French work on the Revolution of July, 1830, and of Feuerbach's Life of Caspar Hauser. He was also a confidant to Alexis de Tocqueville on the customs of the American people in 1832. He received a commission from the trustees of the newly founded Girard College to form a plan of education. This was published at Philadelphia in 1834. He resided in Philadelphia from 1833 until 1835. Then he became a professor of history and political economics at South Carolina College, now the University of South Carolina, where he remained until 1856. During his 20 years at the college, he produced some of his most important works, such writers and jurists as Mittermeier, Johann Caspar Bluntschli, Eduard René de Laboulaye, Joseph Story and James Kent, recognized in him a kindred mind. The spirit of Lieber's work is indicated in his favorite motto, Nullum jus sine officio, nullum officium sine juri, no right without its duties, no duty without its rights. From 1856 until 1865, he was professor of history and political science at Columbia University, then Columbia College. His title was chosen by himself, and made him the first officially designated political scientist in the United States in 1860. He also became professor of political science in the law school, which post he held until his death. His inaugural address as professor at Columbia, on Individualism and Socialism or Communism, was published by the college Civil War Activities. Lieber sided with the North during the American Civil War. Even though he had been a resident of South Carolina as early as 1851, he delivered an address in South Carolina warning the Southern states against secession. One of his sons, geologist Oscar Montgomery Lieber, see below, joined the Confederate Army and died at the Battle of Eltham's Landing during the conflict. Francis Lieber was one of the founders and served as the head of the Loyal Publication Society of New York, compiling news articles for dissemination among Union troops and Northern newspapers. More than 100 pamphlets were issued by it under his supervision, of which 10 were by himself. He also assisted the Union War Department and President Abraham Lincoln in drafting legal guidelines for the Union Army, the most famous being General Orders No. 100, or the Lieber Code, as it is commonly known. The Lieber Code would be adopted by other military organizations and go on to form the basis of the first laws of war. Lieber's contributions and legacy are detailed in the 2012 nonfiction account entitled, Ironically, Lincoln's Code. An abridged version of the Lieber Code was published in 1899 in the War of the Rebellion, a compilation of the official records of the Union and Confederate armies in 1899, preserving Confederate documents after the Civil War. Lieber was given the task of accumulating and preserving the records of the former government of the Confederate States of America. While working in this capacity, Lieber was one of the last known people to possess the infamous Dahlgren Affair papers. Shortly after obtaining them, Lieber was ordered to give them to Secretary of War Edwin M. Stanton, who likely disposed of them, as they have not been seen since diplomacy from 1870 until his death in New York City, aged 72. Francis Lieber served as a diplomatic negotiator between the United States and Mexico. He was chosen, with the united approval of the United States and Mexico, as final arbitrator in important cases pending between the two countries. This work was not completed at his death. Lieber was a member of the French Institute and of many learned societies in the United States and elsewhere. Family. His son Oscar Montgomery Lieber was a geologist during the Civil War. He was killed in action as a member of the Confederate Army. A second son, Hamilton Lieber, the 7th of June 1835, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the 18th of October 1876, Baden-Baden, Germany, entered the Volunteer Army at the beginning of the Civil War as 1st Lieutenant, 9th Illinois Regiment, and was badly wounded at Fort Donelson. Afterward, he was appointed a captain in the Veteran Reserve Corps and served during the draft riots in New York City in 1863. In 1866 he was made a captain and military storekeeper in the regular army, and was retired on account of disabilities contracted in the line of duty. A third son, Guido Norman Lieber, was a United States Army lawyer and jurist during the Civil War. He served in the Union Army and later became a career officer. Works Notes on the Fallacies of American Protectionists, Encyclopaedia Americana Editor, 1829-1851. The Stranger in America, 2 vols, 1833-35. Letters to a Gentleman in Germany, written after a trip from Philadelphia to Niagara, 1834. Reminiscences of an Intercourse with Mr. Niebuhr, the Historian, during a residence with him in Rome, in the years 1822 and 1823. Philadelphia, Carey, Lee. A Manual of Political Ethics, 2 vols. 8 vo, Boston, 1838, adopted by Harvard College as a textbook, and commended by Kent and Story. Legal and Political Hermeneutics, or Principles of Interpretation and Construction in Law and Politics, 1838. Laws of Property, Essays on Property and Labor, 18 mo, New York, 1842. Great Events, described by distinguished historians, chroniclers, and other writers, New York, Harper, 1847. The Unanimity of Juries, 1867. International Copyright, 1840. Numerous Addresses on Anniversary and Other Occasions. Translations. Ramshorn, Lewis, 1841. Dictionary of Latin Synonyms. Little and Brown. Carrot. Francis Lieber. Hermeneutics and Practical Reason. John Catalano. University Press of America, 2000, p. 2. Carrot. Albert Berhardt. Faust, The German Element in the United States, 2 vols, Boston, Houghton Mifflin, 1909, v2, chap 5, p. 216. Carrot. Feintuck, Bert, Waters, David H., eds. 2005. The Encyclopedia of New England. Yale University Press, p. Carrot. Mack, Charles R., Lesson, Henry H., eds. 2005 Franz Lieber and the Culture of the Mind, University of South Carolina Press. Biography from Yale Dictionary of American Legal Biography. Franz Lieber on the Sources of Civil Liberty by Stephen Allen Sampson, V.E. Presidents of the University of South Carolina. Maxey, 1804-1820. Cooper, 1821-1834. Robert Henry, 1834 President Pro Tem Knott, 1834-1835. Chairman of Faculty Barnwell, 1835-1841. Robert Henry, 1841-1845. Preston, 1845-1850. Lieber, 1851 President Pro Tem Thornwell, 1851-1855 Charles F. McKay, 1855-1857 Longstreet, 1857-1861 Laborde, 1861-1865 Chairman of Faculty Barnwell, 1865-1873 Chairman of Faculty Babbitt, 1873-1875 Chairman of Faculty Cummings, 1875-1877 Chairman of Faculty Miles, 1880-1882 McBride, 1883-1891 Woodrow, 1883-1891 Woodward, 1897-1902 Sloan, 1902-1908 Acting, 1902-03 Moore, 1908-1909 Acting Mitchell, 1909-1913 Moore, 1913-1914 Acting Curl, 1914-1922 Melton, 1922-1926 Baker, 1926 Acting Douglas, 1927-1931 Baker, 1931-1936 McKissick, 1936-1944 Baker, 1944-1945 Acting Smith, 1945-1952 Bradley, 1952 Acting Russell, 1952-1957 Sumwalt, 1957-1962 Acting 1957-59 Jones, 1962-1974 Patterson, 1974-1977 Holderman, 1977-1990 Smith, 1990-1991 Acting Palms, 1991-2002 Sorensen, 2002-2008 Pastides, 2008 Present Authority Control World Cat Identities VIAF, 95285806 LCCN, N500504052 ISNI, 0000-0001-1978-3795 GND, 118779923 Sudik, 133033686 BNF, CB 145456159 Data. NLA, 35,304,955.